Good morning, Grade 9 learners! Welcome to the new episode of Valenzuela Live. I am Teacher Elaine, and I am very happy to be your live stream teacher today. Keep calm and use the language as you join me to dig deeper in English today, here at Valenzuela Live. Make sure that you have your copy of the poem we will read today, so you can follow as you listen. Moreover, your handy-dandy pen is essential in taking notes during discussion. For your most essential learning competency, we have determined the relevance and truthfulness of ideas presented in the material viewed. And the sub-skills are, first, interpret the message conveyed in a material viewed. Second, assess the relevance and worth of ideas presented in the material viewed. This is 4.3, lesson 3, assess the relevance and worth of ideas presented in the material viewed. Written by Lea Diodocayen, Master Teacher 1 from Valenzuela National High School. If you are all ready, let's do it! It's activity time! The first activity is entitled, Name That Quote. You will identify the meaning of the underlined quotation in each number using context clues. You have 5 seconds to key in your answer in the comment section below. I know that grade 9 students are very participative. Show me what you've got. Number 1. If you need a shoulder to cry on, I am just one call away. What does a shoulder to cry on mean? A. Someone who listens sympathetically. B. Someone's shoulder for you to hold on when you feel dizzy. Or C. A person who makes you cry. The answer is A. That's right. Number 2. They have been joined at the hip since the time they were in high school. The underlined quotation here is joined at the hip. What does this mean? A. To agree with someone. B. To get on very well with someone. Or C. To be inseparable. Well done! It is letter C. Number 3. Best of friends must stick together through thick and thin. What does through thick and thin mean? A. To be in agreement. B. Through all circumstances, no matter how difficult. C. To socialize with the same people, all of whom have a similar background or lifestyle. Through thick and thin means B. You are ruling it, learners. Number 4. My mom told me that I was too sociable that I tend to hit it off. The underlying quotation is to hit it off. Does it mean A. To end a conflict? B. To find oneself immediately and naturally friendly with someone? C. To agree with someone. The correct answer is B. Is that quote unfamiliar? I see. Number 5. One of my goals as the org president is to build bridges among different groups. What does build bridges mean? A. To promote friendly relations between people or groups. B. To understand someone as a result to share values or opinions. Or C. To know someone very well. As an org president, your responsibility is to build bridges, and that means letter A. You got it right. Next, they had a serious fight but decided to clear the air by sitting together and discussing things frankly. What does the clear the air mean? A. To be very sociable. B. To get on very well with someone. C. To diffuse the tension. The answer is C. Is this no sweat for you? Wow. 7. I was worried that they wouldn't like each other, but in fact, they're getting on like a house on fire. What does getting on like a house on fire mean? A. To love each other. B. To find yourself immediately and naturally friendly with someone. Or C. To get on very well with someone. You are correct if your answer is B. Next quotation we have here, Kai and Enzo could be brothers. They are as alike as two peas in a pod. What does two peas in a pod mean? A. Share the same interests and hobbies. B. To make unlikely buddies. Or C. Very similar. Two peas in a pod means C. Captivity is really very easy for you, right? This is the last. My best pal and I see eye to eye on most things. What does see eye to eye mean? A. To agree with someone. B. Very close. Or C. Very similar. You are correct if you answered A. How many answers did you get right? Impressive. Great job, grade 9 students. Here is a quick glance of all the idioms in this activity. A shoulder to cry on. Join at the hip. True sikante. Hit off. Build bridges. Clear the air. Get on like a house on fire. Two peas in a pod, and see eye to eye. As you notice, these idioms are all related to friendship. Friendship, as understood here, is a distinctively personal relationship that is grounded in a concern on the part of each friend for the welfare of the other. For the other's sake, and that involves some degree of intimacy. As such, friendship is undoubtedly central to our lives. In part, because a special concern we have for our friends must have a place within a broader set of concerns, including moral concerns. And in part, because our friends can help shape who we are as persons. Who can forget the very supportive brotherly friendship and yet at the same time, the most competitive Naruto and Sasuke? How about Gon and Killua from Hunter x Hunter? It's fun to share the same hobbies with your friends, though sometimes we have different preferences with them, just like these TikTok videos. It's fun to have friends, right? Today, we are going to read a poem entitled Be a Friend, written by Edgar A. Guest. Edgar A. Guest was a British-born American poet who became known as the People's Poet. His poems often had an inspirational and optimistic view of everyday life. He worked for more than 60 years at the Detroit Free Press, publishing his first poem at the age of 17. Then, going on to become a reporter and columnist whose work was featured in hundreds of newspapers around the country. Edgar is said to have written some 11,000 poems during his lifetime, most of it sentimental, short, upbeat verse. Critics often derided his work, but America adored him. He was known as the People's Poet, served as Michigan's Poet Laureate, hosted a long-running radio show and TV show, and published more than 20 books. Some of his famous works are The Path to Home, A Dozen New Poems, Sunny Psalms, Keep Going, When the Day is Done, Don't Quit. Also, others are Making the House a Home, The Passing Throng, Rhymes of Childhood, Mother, The Light of Faith, Secret of the Ages, and You. Are you ready to listen to the poem, Be a Friend? Before that, let me give the guide questions you will be answering later. First, what is the poem all about? Second, what makes someone a friend? Third, what messages does the author want to give the readers? Sit back and relax and try to answer the guide questions as you read while listening to the poem.
Be a friend. You don't need money, just a disposition sunny, just the wish to help another, get along some way or other, just a kindly hand extended out to one who's unbefriended, just the will to give or lend, this will make you someone's friend. Be a friend, you don't need glory, friendship is a simple story. Pass by trifling errors blindly, gaze on honest effort kindly, cheer the youth who's bravely trying, pity him who's sadly sighing, just a little labor spend on the duties of a friend. Be a friend, the pay is bigger, though not written by a figure, than is earned by people clever, and what's merely self-endeavor. You'll have friends instead of neighbors, for the profits of your labors. You'll be richer in the end than a prince, if you're a friend.
Let's go back to the guide questions. Number 1. What is the poem all about? 2. What makes someone a friend? 3. What message does the author want to give the readers? Obviously, the poem is about friendship, or how beautiful it is to have a friend or be someone's friend. In the first stanza, the poet says that to be a friend, you don't need money. Instead, you just need to have the will to get along with others. The will to extend a hand to people who don't have friends. And the will to give and lend. Also, the speaker explains that it doesn't cost any money to be a good friend. We just have to have a cheerful, helpful, generous attitude and be willing to reach out to others. In the second stanza, the poet says that friendship does not require glory, only the willingness to overlook small faults, reward effort, and pity those who need help. Also, the second stanza lists some of the duties of friendship. We should forgive our friends, encourage them in whatever they are trying to do, and share in their sadness. In the last stanza, the poet states that friendship will reap larger rewards than endeavors earn large sums of money from cleverness. If you are a good friend, you'll have friends, not merely neighbors, and be richer than a prince. Lastly, the third stanza points out that although smart people who only work for their own benefit do earn a lot of money, we can earn a more valuable kind of wealth by being friendly. That is, all of our neighbors will be our friends. That makes us richer than royalty. Moving on to the figurative languages, our poem has verses and rhyme. It is defined as when a poem has lines ending with words that sound the same. In this poem, rhyme is used in couplets that do not repeat. This gives the author more room with words and creates a smooth-flowing poem. As well, many people are accustomed to rhyme poems from our lessons from childhood, so this style of rhyme is successful not only by the flow of it, but by the history behind many people that draws them to such poems. He also never repeats a rhymed word, with the exception of friend, and demonstrates the versatility of rhymes, specifically those that are attached to friend. Second, repetition. Repetition of the word friend by repeating the word friend throughout the poem. The author solidifies his theme of being a friend. The rhyming structure also helps with this by connecting both the line ending in friend and the line ending in the rhyming word seamlessly and making it memorable, as we tend to remember things that rhyme. Third, symbolism. Symbolism is used immediately in line 1, just a disposition sunny. The use of the words disposition sunny makes them a symbol for having a happy, cheerful attitude. Also, be a friend, the pay is bigger. Though not written by a figure, lines 16 to 17 also uses symbolism using figure in the sentence to mean that the pay the author is talking about is not monetary in value. By using symbolism, he keeps the poem flowing smoothly and creates memorable lines. Fourth, personification. Personification is used in line 5, giving a hand that human emotion of kindness. While the hand presumably belongs to a human, the hand itself is not kind, and thus can be considered an object. This personification pushes the reader to realize that kindness to others, as well as being helpful, is a part of becoming a real friend. Fifth, ellipsis. It is the omission of a word or words. It refers to construction in which words are left out of a sentence, but the sentence can still be understood. For example, Tina can speak two languages, but Rina can speak only one, omitting the word languages. By his skillful cutting of words that would otherwise make some of the sentences proper in their grammar, notably lines 12, 14, and 18, the author maintains flow as well as understanding by the reader. Lastly, author's message. The persona in the text encourages us to show compassion to others, tend to be both helpful and kind. In return for this effort, we'll experience the wealth that comes with having many friends. I am giving you the opportunity to raise questions in the comment section. You have 1 minute for that. Time is up. The first question is from Malinta National High School. What is the central idea of the poem? The poem Be a Friend focuses on the importance of friendship and the duties and responsibilities that come with being a friend. The poem dwells on the fact that true friendship rises above materialistic needs such as money and as such, and rather focuses on the importance on the bond between the two friends. The next is from Valenzuela National High School. What is the significance of having a true friend? Friends can help you celebrate good times and provide support during bad times. Friends prevent isolation and loneliness and give you a chance to offer needed companionship too. You should know that you don't need a lot of them. As Proverbs 18:24 said, a man of many companions may come to ruin, but there is a friend who stays closer than a brother. If you have unanswered queries, your subject teachers will be very willing to assist you in the follow-up discussion. This has been Teacher Elaine. Thank you for digging deeper in the language with me today. See you again here at Valenzuela Live, where distance is never a hindrance to learning. Keep calm and stay friendly, learners. See ya!